there, and thank you for dropping by. Now we're going to a good trip and adventure to India. I cannot believe.
All right, we arrived by sea on Celebrity Cruises on the Constellation ship, and I went on one of the most amazing excursions I've ever been on. Here's my wife on the left, right before we embarked to customs to India. Now, I've heard some very fantastic stories about India, and I didn't know if they were true. I thought it was a lot of hype, but famous people such as Oprah Winfrey, the Beatles, and so on have went to this part of the world and found answers. And I'll have to say, as I go on like this, unless you go there, you wouldn't understand. But it was quite a thing. But before I went to India, I thought it was all a bunch of baloney, a bunch of bullshit, or a bunch of bullshitters. But when I went there, my eyes were opened, and I was what you could call enlightened. Here's our guide and guru, Ash. In India, I learned it's the journey, not the destination. And I never got what that meant till I arrived to India. And here's a shot of Ash giving us all the guidance and story behind India. He was such a fantastic guide. I even heard he was the guide for the Clinton family when they went to India. Cows are sacred in India, and you'll see them roam free, especially after they're not producing milk, they're let free.
Tiger!
Tiger in the high!
Most dogs are feral in India. They roam free. They don't tend to mess with you unless you mess with them, but they will bite you, and they do carry rabies, some of these dogs, but if you leave them alone, they generally leave you alone. When I was in India, I looked for a snake charmer. They're very hard to find because the snakes, they pull the fangs out and they only live months or a few months after they pulled them out. But they're hard to find. I didn't see any.
Here I am with my new friend. Say hi. Hi from India. Thank you. Here I am, you can see people here lack better etiquette, but I'm here down in downtown Bombay in the jewelry section. Alright. You can tell this guy doesn't a little too local for me. But here we are. And it's amazing here.
On my trip to India, it was very photo and video friendly. The only place I ran into a little bit of trouble with photography and video was the Taj Mahal. Here's my wife at one of the buildings I photographed her at. Airport, and the next we used SpiceJet, and we weren't really too thrilled about it. The seats were small, the service, they're real kind of snooty with us. And again, here in the next picture, our great guru guide, Ash. And coming up, the Triton Hotel, one of the nicest places I've ever stayed in the world. Triton Hotel, you are treated like royalty. Any alcohol you want to drink, it's free. The best Indian food I've ever eaten anywhere in the world at the Triton. It was just beyond belief. Anything you asked for, they provided it. I've never stayed in a place that had such good service anywhere. And when we stayed in the Middle East or anything, those hotels did not have a candlestick to this hotel in India. I was speechless, and I've never been treated so well. I didn't want to go back to our cruise ship. I was treated so well, I could have lived in there. It was just unbelievably great service, great food. It was a paradise. It was like living in a royal palace in India. It was just freaking amazing. If you ever go to India, I would highly recommend this hotel. And for the price and everything it costs, it is just off the charts. And we had such a good time. There's my wife, and then here's myself. Then we headed out to another hotel to eat, but it didn't compare to the Triton. And that's what these other photos were as we went to this other hotel to also have like a lunch. Alright, we headed out to the train station in India, and that was quite an experience. I guess it's not too far where they filmed the Slumdog Millionaire. Here was our guide, Ash, guiding us through the railroad station and to our train. He was amazing. I can't express and tell you how great we could even have managed through India without this man. He like knew everything about India. He knew all the ins and outs, and he was such a great guy. I've never had a guide anywhere I've traveled. He's just knowledgeable, kind, nice, and thoughtful, and just took care of everyone in our group. I mean, Celebrity Cruises knocked it out of the park getting this man. They did a great job. I just wordless to tell you what a great, great guide this man was. He really made a huge impact and difference on us in India. Our trip wouldn't have been near the same without this man.
In there? You hop on here.
Here's a photo I took of Ash right before we hopped on the train. Here's another photo. Our friend with the backpack backwards is Dale, and he's over to the right. My wife in the middle, me to the left. Here is the lunch they provided for us on our train ride to Taj Mahal. One thing India is struggling with is air quality. because of the Cadillac converters missing off many of their vehicles, also trash is burned. It makes it very smoggy and foggy there and difficult to breathe. So it's not unusual to see people wearing masks in India, and that's why.
I've done that in tours before. I just jump in with like where the cruise ship tour is and kind of tail behind that just for like, the safety. You know?
Now I see how they're feeding everybody. There's a lot of more agriculture out here, so that's how they're feeding them all.
All right, be warned, in India, when you use the bathroom, bring toilet paper. Unless you stay in a nice hotel, they provide it there. But most of all your public bathrooms that I went to in India, it's a hole in the ground and there's no toilet paper. There's water you can shoot up there, but you need to bring your own toilet paper. As you can see, getting off and on trains and buses and airplanes, you just about have to have a guide in India. It's very difficult if you don't. We've exited our last train and now we are making our way to the Taj Mahal. Pretty soon you'll see, like in the next spring's coming up, the tourist signs of the Taj Mahal.
Alright, here I'm going through a line in India, just getting off the train, heading to the Taj Mahal. We'll be right back.
coming up in this frame. As soon as they're coming up, you'll see a man on the left. He's going to spit right on the ground. Here's one of the nice guests. I think she's Canadian. They was on our ship that gave the gentleman a bottle. But what I was surprised in India was the lack of like disabled people. I expected to see many, many more. In fact, where I'm in California, we have a lot more than what I saw, and I went all over India. And you can see all the photographs of saying we have more here than I saw in India, and we have many more beggars that are more aggressive and dangerous, where the people in India, they actually offer you something. They don't beg outright, and they're much more kind and gentle and thoughtful than the ones here in California. They may kill you or attack you. So I was very, very surprised to see that and how everyone gets along in India. It's really, really, you just have to go there to see it, how it all operates. The film can show you some of it, but take a look at places we live in California. You see rows and miles of tents of beggars and drug addicts. Didn't see anything like that in India, like we have here. And a picture of my wife, and then the next picture, some locals saying hello to us.
Make some noise! Now scream!
All right, after a long bus trip, we neared the Taj Mahal, and we started coming up to the gates. As we went on our bus trip, you could start seeing the traffic was starting to back up, and more cars were parked. Then pretty soon there's the outer gates, which look like right where this dog is sitting up here to the left to the Taj Mahal. That's very much what the gates look like. I know that says golf course there, but the gates of the Taj Mahal, when you get to the first line of security, look very similar to those exact gates. Now we're stopped here, kind of on waiting in traffic to get to those gates. In the next frame, you're going to see come here, you'll see my wife at the bottom left going onto the first security gates as you go into the Taj Mahal. Here's a friend we made on the ship. Her name was Carol, and we took a little rickshaw ride to the beginning of the Taj Mahal. Alright, as you pull up to the Taj Mahal, you'll see monkeys, and I love monkeys. Now, there's two different types of monkeys in the Taj Mahal or in that area, and this type was the friendlier type. There is a type that's more aggressive and feel that you're on risk, but they let me get pretty close to filming, but I was nervous that they would attack me, and they can mess you up, let me tell you. I noticed this gentleman, he was a Sikh dressed in orange. He kind of followed us around, but he might have been a security force assigned to us, not sure. All right, here's the lines to get in the Taj Mahal. There's thousands. And our guide, there's my wife in the blue waving, got us ahead of the line of everybody. I think it's a few dollars more, but he covered it all and got us in there. It's not like Disneyland where they pack everyone inside. They make everyone wait outside. They keep the numbers less than the Taj Mahal. Now, we just gotten in here through the security force. And now, this next building you walk through, and you're at the Taj Mahal.
So I'm here. Thank you.
started winding our trip up at the Taj Mahal. We went back up front, and then we did a fantastic front back. We got rip shots. I kind of bugged Ash more, and he was kind of apprehensive, but he okayed it. Here's a shot of the guards. Pretty soon you see a picture of me, and I even slipped a few bills to my driver, and he let me drive. And you'll see one here of my wife getting ready to drive too. It was a blast. Wow, we wound up the rickshaw ride. Driving one of those was just off the charts. You have to do it if you ever go. You have to ride one. If you can drive one, even better. And then we headed off to this great fort. There was a gentleman out there who was walking around, and I had a photograph. But this fort was built by the Mughals. I think that's how you pronounce it. Shoot me if I got it wrong, but I'm doing my best to pronounce this. Anyways, the great builders, ancestors of the Mongols, but the Mughals were the great builders. Now this awesome fort, and it is built to the T, you can look right over to the Taj Mahal, and there are monkeys on the wall, there are birds in there, there's chipmunks. Very cool place. It's a must stop go when you go to the Taj Mahal in Agra. So you need to go there. It's easy to find. And then right up there, you look through the wall, there's the Taj Mahal. And how I understand it, that smoke there is cremation being done. And that's a little bit of quabble going on being done there. And there's my little friend the monkey, supposed for a picture for me. But awesome place. Place to check out. And I had a great time there. Filming everything. No issues. No problems filming. Awesome stop. Very, very mad. Mad. So you're thinking to go to India now? You should. It's amazing. Get the passport, get your documentation, and go there. It's unbelievable. All the hype and hoopla that you hear about it, it's true. It's very true. You will think different once you come back from India. Me and my wife both had a vision when we were there. I know this sounds like baloney, but we both talked to people that were in our past. We both talked to someone that is no longer here on Earth at the same place, at the same time. As here's some of those sacred cows, so you note these ones are tied up, so they're still producing milk. When they don't produce milk anymore, they'll let them go. They wander on themselves. So all this hype and hoopla about India, is it true? You bet it is. It changed the way I think about culture, about people. And it's just amazing. The Hindu culture, you should really look into it. It is the oldest written religion in the world. It's older than Christianity, it's older than the Hebrew, and it's older than Islam. And it has a lot of interesting features that all of them have shared and got from the Hindu religion. So check it out, find out for yourself. I did, and I say go to India. It'll change the way you think. All right, Indigo Airline. Good airline, bigger seats, better service. We were happy with it. Then we went back to our celebrity cruise ship, which was the Constellation. And what do you know? A Bollywood theater show. It was amazing. What a way to end our trip with. And then here's some photos of myself, my wife, and myself again in India. All right, let's hear your great comments if you've been to India, Agra, Taj Mahal, Bollywood. I want to hear them. Write down there and tell me. All right, sub to us and keep traveling.